gentlemen, the show is about to start in 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Albert, and today we celebrate it with a brief history of your life in pictures. We start by going way back to your birth. Well, maybe not so way. Now, maybe not so back. Closer. Closer. The eventful year was 1963. Throughout the year, the war in Vietnam was well underway, as was the civil rights movement. The world was still mourning the loss of Norma Jean Mortensen, aka Marilyn Monroe, from the previous summer. Speaking of Monroe, John F. Kennedy spent a busy first half a year working on implementing the Civil Rights Act, resulting in federal troops confronting racist Governor George Wallace, who tried to prevent black students from attending a public school in June. Meanwhile, in Hollywood, Tippi Hedren was given the birds. The Beatles wanted to hold your hand and please, please me. The Supremes hit the charts with When the Love Light Shines Through His Eyes. When the love light starts shining through his eyes, made me realize I'm still a part of that. And we place our kiss upon my face, then I'm beautiful. And Elvis hit number one with You're the Devil in Disguise.
You're the devil in disguise.
The next time you go looking for a special kind of toy, look for Cecil the Sea Serpent and Lovable Beanie Boy. Here's Funny Cecil, a crazy kind of guy. You'll find you really love him, and here's the reason why. He's got a silly nose, and he's got no toes. And great big eyes that go round and round. Oh, and here's a surprise. He comes in this size, and this size. Now, if you pull the magic ring, Big C's might say anything.
I'm coming, Beanie!
And here's Lovable Beanie Boy, another wonderful Mattel-made toy. He's got a little pug nose and a great big grin. And look at his cap. You can make it spin. With Beanie Boy, you'll find there's two. And the bigger one will talk to you.
Where is Cecil?
There goes our good kid. Cecil and Beanie Boys are lovable and huggable. You can tell them a tell. They're swell.
The Thunderbird was hot. The Queen accepted a drink from one of Britain's subject countries. And Albert was born on November 10th, just 12 days before the world would be shocked by the assassination of JFK. Albert would grow up to live a fairly normal life. Like most boys his age, Albert hated school. He ran away once and lived in a car for a little while before returning home. He was always a hard worker. His first job was at the local Wave Tech pool. Other early jobs was at KFC and the Pokey Dot restaurant. Around this time, Albert got his first apartment. Then he invested in his beloved Thunderbird, which was borrowed by a friend who wrecked it and then hid away from Albert. Albert then went to work for an insurance company and stayed there throughout numerous name changes until it shut down about 20 years later. It was during his employment there that I met Albert, and I moved down from Cumberland, Maryland, and his life would never be the same. He was introverted, me not so much. We ended up getting a half of a duplex house. We ended up getting half a duplex house owned by a slumlord. Getting fed up with no help from the landlord and not happy there, Albert decided to invest in his own home. He already had one picked out, and that is the one he got. At first, it looked like a Brady Bunch home, but after some remodeling, it was soon updated. With me being a DJ and having plenty of music and equipment, the house kind of became a weekend party house for, well, most of the 90s. Then during the 2000s, we recuperated. After the insurance company closed, Albert went from being a computer programmer to an overall handyman for 17 years at the hotel. The hotel would change hands and names quite a few times. Then I started having some health problems, and Albert started taking care of me. Several strokes later, and Albert really had to kick in and take up the slack caused by my disabilities, which left me practically homebound. He left his job in 2021 to take care of his mom and I, and now he just takes care of me. He has been my filming partner on YouTube, my best friend, full-time companion, and caregiver for 34 years. He's also at times been my greatest enemy and biggest critic. And tonight we celebrate his life with just a few people who have something they want to say. Take it away, folks.
November 10, 1963, 59 years ago today. Wow, 59 years ago when gas cost 30 cents a gallon and cigarettes 35 cents a pack and JFK was president, well, at least for another 12 days. You were born. I lagged behind by another 5 years, and although our families knew each other for years, you and I didn't meet until Harlem Street in 1982, when you were 19. In 1982, a gallon of gas cost $1.22, and a pack of cigarettes, 81.9 cents, with a looming threat of a tax, the first tax cigarette tax hike, taking them to a whole dollar a pack. Ronald Reagan was president. I remember thinking back then that you were so much older than us. You had a steady job. You had your own car. You had an apartment over on, what was it, Kelly Place at the end of the 3rd Street Bridge. Remember, we would take that Ford Fiesta or Chevette that you taught me how to drive a stick in, and we would get lost over on the knob and stuck in the snow, and we'd help other people get unstuck from the snow. A few years after that, well, a lot of years after that, You cooked all the food for me and David's wedding, which is a huge gift indeed. And I remember when, like a year later, and me and David got divorced, you and Terry welcomed me into your home for the pool and for New Year's Eve so I wouldn't be alone. You got me a job at Quality Insurance after Levi was born. We've been friends for 40 years, Albert. 40 years we've been friends. Now, gas costs $3.85 a gallon. Cigarettes cost $8.80 a pack. We have a joke for a president that was not elected but placed. But we're still friends. My wish for you, my friend, is that you celebrate each day of your life for the marvel and wonder that it is. And it gives you, and it can be. Really drink it all in, knowing and believing that you, you kind-hearted, loving man, you deserve the very best that life has to offer you, and you are worth every good thing. Thank you for sharing some of your adventures with me, and may you wish, 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 and capture each and every one of them easily. Happy birthday, my friend. Happy, happy birthday.
Happy birthday, happy birthday, happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday, Al.
Hi, Terry.
I just want to wish you many, many blessings and many more birthdays to come. Have a nice, blessed, wonderful birthday, evening, night as you celebrate. I know I said this before, but I want to say it again. You guys both are sweet, talented, creative, amazing, beautiful people. And I am so proud to be a fan as well as a friend. And I just want to take this moment to say to any new viewers that might be in here on this beautiful channel, you're in the right place. People here are loving, kind, awesome people. We have an awesome community also. You will not go wrong. You will fall in love with this place. It's inspiring, uplifting, and positive. You'll like it here just like I did. All you gotta do is hit that red button down below and ding that bell. Do it for Al's birthday. Anyways, happy birthday, Al. I love you guys. I wish you guys longevity, good health, success, lots of love, and an abundance of happiness and prosperity. Much love and light, blessings, peace, and I'll see you soon, somewhere in this world, like internet. Aloha!
Hi, Albert. It's Nancy, or Nancy VU on YouTube. I want to say happy birthday. I wish you the best birthday. May you be blessed with many, many more years to come, filled with lots of love, happiness, and health. Enjoy it. Eat lots of cake. Lots and lots of cake. And see you soon. Bye.
Happy birthday, Albert, from Rhode Island, Heather Sheldon, as known as No One Cares. Have a happy birthday.
What's up, everyone? Marie's Life Vlogs here, and I want to wish my good friend Albert a happy birthday. I got my friend here. He wanted to come to the party. We're celebrating with the balloons. Happy birthday, Albert. Tell him happy birthday.
Happy birthday. Happy birthday. Happy birthday.
I hope you have a wonderful day. Bye.
Hi, Al. It's Aunt Em. I wanted to wish you a very happy birthday. I hear you have a special one coming up, and I wanted to send along my love as well. You have a great birthday. Party hard. It's your day. I love you guys.
Happy birthday to my other brother from a different mother. I love and miss you, Peppy. I hope to see you very soon. Give all my love Remember, we're not getting older. We are getting older. I love you. Mwah!
Hi, Terry and Albert. Albert, hope you have a happy birthday from me and from the kiddies. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Albert. Happy birthday to you.
I just want to wish you a very happy birthday, Al, and I hope you have a blessed day, and I hope your day is filled with joy, love, and laughter. Also, hi, Terry. Welcome, guys, from Scotland. Have a great day. Blessed be.
Hey, Albert. It's your birthday. And I wish I was there. But you got my beautiful face right here, okay? It looks the same as always. And I miss working with you so much. I hate not seeing you every single day. You are truly my best friend, even if we don't get to see or talk often. But I love you, and I hope you have a happy birthday. So, happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Albert. Happy birthday to you. I love you.
Hey, Albert. It's your girl, Jessie. I wanted to wish you a very happy birthday. I hope your day is awesome, full of much fun and blessings. Make sure Terry gets you a nice cake or whatever you like. And I hope your day's amazing. Happy birthday, Albert.
Kia ora, Albert. Hari hura tau ki a koi means happy birthday in Māori. And I certainly hope you do have a great happy birthday and a fantastic day. Don't do anything I wouldn't do. So big loves, araha nui, ahi hahi Māori, bye from New Zealand.
Hey Al, it's your old friend Fred from lovely Western Maryland. Just putting my face out there today to wish you a happy 39th birthday. 39 is a milestone. I certainly wish you had 39 more. Cheers.
Happy birthday, Al, from Australia, and me, Evie. I hope you have a wonderful birthday.
Hey, Albert. Jim and I would like to wish you the happiest birthday ever. Hope you enjoy the balloons and confetti. Happy birthday.
Happy birthday,
Albert, and many more.
Hey, Al. I'm Jim. Old friend of Terry's. I just wanted to wish you a happy birthday. Terry reached out to me and asked if I would, you know, because I'm on your spirit page. But anyway, I just wanted to wish you a happy birthday and many more. Bye bye.
Happy birthday, Albert. Thanks for the fun tour and good food in West Virginia or wherever we were.
West Virginia.
Fairmont.
Yeah, happy birthday, Albert. Hope you have a nice day.
Hello, Albert. Even though we haven't seen each other in a while, you're always present in my mind, and I always remember those days when I stayed at your house and Terry's house. Have a nice day. Happy birthday. Feliz cumpleaños. Muy feliz cumpleaños. Que los cumplas muy feliz.
Hi, Albert. Happy birthday, honey. Hope you all have a really good day. Love you guys. Hi, Terry. There's my one-eyed cat.
Happy birthday, Albert. Enjoy your special day. Can't wait to see you.
Happy birthday. Happy birthday, Brother Albert. I love you, and I hope you have an amazing day. Love you guys. Happy birthday.
Hello, Albert. Tell me it was your birthday. I'd like to wish you a happy birthday. And I hope you have an amazing day. Hugs, my friend.
Bye. birthday to you.
Albert, may your troubles be less and your blessings be more, and nothing but happiness come through your door. As you slide down the banister of life, may the splinters never point in the wrong direction. Happy birthday.
That's the end?